Some floodwaters in northern New South Wales are beginning to recede, allowing residents to return home to assess the scale of the disaster. The NSW State Emergency Service has announced residents in low-lying areas of Mullumbimby, Condong, Tumbulgum, and low-lying parts of Kyogle can return home. Meanwhile in Lismore, the council said the Wilson's River is slowly receding and has fallen below the height of the levee which overtopped yesterday. The incredible letter sent from Jason Warne to his big brother Shane. Houses are surrounded by flood water in Lismore. The river now sits at 10.47 metres, after peaking at 11.4 metres last night. River levels are likely to remain above the major flood level on Thursday, Lismore City Council said on Facebook. An aged care worker, feared swept away by floodwaters, remains missing in Lismore, and the dangerous weather system is tracking south. As a volatile weather system circles off the coast, the response of the NSW SES and Bureau of Meteorology came under fire, with officials accusing the services of slow updates. Fields are flooded and houses completely submerged in the Lismore floods. Airport closed due to floods. All commercial flights in and out of Ballina Byron Airport today and tomorrow have been cancelled due to the flood disaster. Limited services will be operating over the weekend. The airport is shut as the runway needs to dry out before commercial flights can resume. Local resident Kathy Jordan inspects flood water in her street in Lismore. Storm system heads south. While heavy rain is set to ease today over northern NSW, another weather warning has been issued further south. Strong winds are being felt across the state, with a gale warning issued for NSW's north, down to the south coast. NSW Emergencies Minister Steph Cook said communities south of the northern rivers were going to be impacted. Dean Naramore said moderate and major flooding were still ongoing. The weather system is making its way down the east coast, and we will see other communities impacted as it moves south over the next couple of days, Ms. Cook said. Communities that live on or near the Wilsons, Richmond, Clarence and Yarrara rivers, particularly downstream where the flood events are current, have been urged to stay up to date with the latest forecast and warnings. Residents can keep across evacuation orders here. Russia shells areas in Ukraine where it vowed to scale back. A low pressure system is swirling off the NSW coast, while a slow moving high pressure system is south of the Bight. The bomb has also issued a damaging surf warning for people in parts of mid-north coast, Hunter, Metropolitan, Illawarra, and South Coast forecast districts. Damaging surf along central and southern NSW coast developing Thursday afternoon. Abnormally high tides possible along parts of the mid-north coast from Thursday morning, it said. The sea is being whipped by a low-pressure system, which currently lies about 280 kilometres off northern NSW, while a slow-moving high-pressure system is situated south of the Bight. A severe weather warning is also in place from Kempsey, south to the Victorian border, warning of abnormally high tides, dangerous surf and strong, gusty winds. Coastal erosion is also possible, particularly on south-facing beaches. Mr. Naramore said the worst was expected today and tomorrow. Local residents inspect a flooded road in Lismore. More than 20 flood warnings for river systems are in place across the north and mid-north coast down to Sydney's Hawkesbury, where a minor flood warning has been issued. A main street is under flood water in Lismore. NSW says Deputy Commissioner Daniel Austin has warned that while the threat of flash flooding from rainfall is diminished, significant riverine flooding was still ongoing. That water needs to discharge through these systems, he said. The riverine threat is certainly not over at this point in time. The SES received just over 100 calls for assistance in the past 24 hours, including 11 flood rescues. Most of the rescues were during the day yesterday, with communities caught by rapid rising flash floods on the mid-north coast. Local heroes helping Lismore in floodwaters. Residents watch in horror as town is swallowed by floodwaters. Search for missing aged care nurse. Police have issued an urgent appeal for information as the search for a missing 55-year-old continues. Anita Brakel was last seen in her car on Tuesday evening. NSW Police Assistant Commissioner Joe Kasser said Ms. Brakel, who originally lived in Nowra, had been recruited to Lismore as an aged care worker. Anita Brakel, 55, is an aged care nurse currently missing in Lismore floodwaters. Floodwater inundate cars in Lismore. Evacuation orders have been issued for towns across the NSW Northern Rivers region, with flash flooding amid heavy rainfall. It's the second time the town has flooded in a month, with February bringing a flood peak of more than 14 metres. Despite this flood, the NSW says Lismore City Unit reports there were very few flood rescue jobs over the past 48 hours. In total, the unit were tasked with just under 100 requests for assistance, including flood evacuations, support and storm jobs. Fire and rescue NSW teams were also on hand to assist and helped paramedics reach an 8-year-old boy suffering from COVID-19 isolated by floodwaters at Buka, north of Coffs Harbour. The Lismore SES unit thanked the wonderfully responsive community for heading warnings. The NSW said its Lismore headquarters started to fill up shortly after 6 a.m. yesterday. About 6,000 people remain without power, with Deputy Commissioner Austin noting many infrastructure challenges in the Northern Rivers. We see many businesses and homes, and including some of the emergency services in the community, that are still in a state of repair, he said. We will continue to work as quickly as we can to restore those, and I am confident that those issues have not hampered our response during this particular time. Ballina residents begin cleanup. Ballina residents have also criticised a lack of evacuation warnings as they woke up to a town underwater yesterday morning. Longtime Byron resident Mark Wilson told Nine News the flooding was the worst I've ever seen. Mark Wilson has lived in Byron for 35 plus years. He said he's never seen a storm like the one that blew through yesterday. People walk through floodwater in Byron. Words can't describe what we went through, he said. We knew a storm was coming, just not to the extreme it did come. Otherwise, I'm sure a lot of these shops would have sandbagged and done a lot of preparation if they knew it would be as severe as it was. The Ballina SES unit was smashed with requests yesterday amid extensive flash flooding. Many homes and businesses remain without power. As of 5 p.m. yesterday, they had received 169 requests for help, excluding flood rescues and unrecorded evacuations. NSW says Ballina crews attend a swift water rescue. An SES worker secures himself to a rope as he enters floodwaters to inspect a trapped truck. This brings the total to 214 recorded jobs over the past 3 days, it wrote on Facebook. Over the past 24 hours, there has been 282 millimetres of rainfall, and the Richmond River peaked at 2.38 m at 8:30 a.m.